It's Allison, and I'm here with episode 4 of Leading Edge Fan Questions and Answers. We have got an overwhelming response this week from all of your questions, so I'm going to get straight to it and see how many of them I can answer. We really appreciate everyone sending in all of their questions. We learn something every day trying to make sure we have the right answer. You know, we have some recall on what's going on. So keep those questions coming in, and remember, you can email them to me, you can send them on Facebook, on our page. Any way they get to me, we're going to try to answer them the best we can. If we don't get to your question this week, stay tuned for next week, and remember to like and subscribe to this channel, because then you won't miss a single episode. So here we go. So our first question is from Mary, and Mary has a breed that is newly recognized by the American Kennel Club. They're Moody's. And they are a herding breed that kind of is supposed to be untrimmed and have a coarser kind of coat. Mary, I would recommend bathing once a week. Now, you said that you didn't bath them like on such a regular basis, but just like anything else, clean hair is going to grow and have the proper texture. If the dog does have the proper texture, bathing in the proper products is not going to soften that texture. So a few things that I have for you are: the regular bathing would be a must for me. That clean hair is going to shine through. The regular texture is going to be there. The biggest mistake people make is they take a dog that's double coated or supposed to have a harsher texture, and then when they only bath it once in a while, they are then stripping out all those oils. The skin isn't used to it, and that's when the hair reacts not favorably to us. I would dry them and keep them as much as possible between the time that they have their show bath until they get to a show on a flat surface. So I would keep them on a rack, like a crate rack, to dry, and then either on a crate rack with paper underneath it or like a satin bed that you might suspect a shih tzu or something to be on. The reason is this, is that cotton beds or a terry cloth towel, etc., for them to lay on will make that coat look fuzzy. Clearly it won't change the texture. So, you know, for those dogs that are supposed to have some natural curl to their hair without that fuzzy look, use a rack or a satin type bed. But I find a rack works the absolute best. And my recommendations for you, I would just use Chris Christensen Day to Day or Clean Start Shampoo, because that's just going to get the hair clean. It's not going to soften it, give it more texture, do any of those things that you don't want. You could also use a Spectrum 1 if you did want to just add back a little bit of texture. It is made for more rough coated breeds. So good luck with that, Mary, and I really hope that you do well at your first show, and keep us posted. Let us know how you do for student success. It was great to get your question. Our next question is from Barbara, and she has a Tibetan Spaniel, and she was really cute in her email because she said that she's terrible with hair. She has short hair. Her granddaughters know enough not to ask grandma to help with pigtails or anything. And she had a picture, which I love to get pictures, of her Tibetan Spaniel. And you could see that his top line was indeed nice and level, but it was just the hair was giving her that problem. He has kind of that shawl marking that a lot of dogs get over the shoulders, you know, just the way the hair grows. And then it made the dog look lumpy in the center of his back and then kind of falling off before the tail. So if you can picture that, I think a lot of us have had that same problem. So Barbara, what I would do is I would make sure that you really rake out the center of his top line, like underneath that shawl. You're going to use either a really fine tooth comb or maybe a coat king and just rake out any extra undercoat. That being said, I didn't really see any extra undercoat in that photo. It looked pretty good. I don't think that Tame It is necessarily the shampoo that I would use on him. I think that's a great shampoo, and maybe if you still have some, I would use it on his furnishings, like on his pants, his tail, and his bib. But for his body coat, I would prefer that you use something like Spectrum 1, and that you really shampooed it in there, and then you use Thick and Thicker by Chris Christensen, volume response thickening conditioning foaming agent. So the way I use it is I put like maybe a quarter size amount in my hands, and I rub it in my hands, and you're going to see it's going to get foamy. Then I'm going to work it in all those areas that you want some extra control and a bit of extra lift. So right in front of his tail set, but even around the shawl, just to give it like a little bit of gumption, like where you want it to go. Then this is the important part. When you dry him, use, if you're using a velocity dryer, you can use the velocity dryer and kind of dry the parts of his top line that are down, like are flatter backwards against the grain. and obviously dry the other parts with the grain laying down. Now here's the important part. Even if you use a velocity dryer, I want you to use a hot dryer afterwards. So even just your own hand dryer, although you might not have one, so borrow your granddaughter's, and use the hot hand dryer and really work that coat backwards and make sure it's really dry at the root so that you're reminding the hair what way to go. You're gonna dry the parts that are lower backwards and the parts that are higher forwards, but really using a lot of pressure on the brush on the parts that are going forward to get that hair nice and flat. And I would also recommend maybe like a damp towel, like a small damp towel in the middle of his back right before I go in the ring to keep that flat. So Barbara, if this doesn't work for you, just send me another message and we'll work through this, okay? But I think that's the place to start. All right, here we go. I told you there was lots of questions today. So Wheatley Wears is jumping in on the action, and we love our friends at Wheatley Wears. They're completely awesome. They help you with anything you want. So if you're Canadian, you need some products, you need some Chris Christensen, these people have the best customer service. We love them. So you can also use our discount code, which is LEDSA. LEDSA is the discount code for 10% off anything Chris Christensen through our friends at Wheatley Wears. So their question was about Havanese. I guess they have lots of Havanese clients and customers. So they wanted to know what was the best brush, comb, shampoo, and conditioner for somebody with a Havanese. So my go-to brush would be the Gold Series Oval 27mm. Love this brush. The reason I love the Gold Series is its anti-static properties. I mean, it's a high quality brush, but you're gonna have it for 10 years. So if you take that money and divide it over 10 years, it's really like only $6 or $7 a year that you're spending on that brush. Keep the box that it comes in, keep the brush in the box when you're not using it so the pins don't get bent. I would use the Big G Slicker, which I affectionately call the Coral Slicker. For Havanese, you're gonna wanna buy it in medium. Look out for it coming out in a smaller size anytime this fall. But yes, the Big G, otherwise known as the Coral Slicker if you're talking to me or see any of my videos, in medium, that slicker, it will save your life because it has 30% more pins than any other slicker that's out there. So you're doing one third of the less work when you're using that slicker. I love it. Really any comb will do. Probably your most basic 7.5 half and half comb. Half is a little bit coarser, half is a little bit finer. That's gonna do you great. My shampoo would be, for a Havanese, would be Chris Christensen Tame It, made for those kind of coats. But here's where I would veer off the beaten path. I wouldn't use the Tame It conditioner. If you have it, use it. If you don't, save yourself some time, buy After Bath. Chris Christensen After the Bath conditioner is an awesome lightweight conditioner, but cuts your drying time by 30%, boys and girls. So 30% your time back to you. So thanks Cheryl and Mike from Wheatley Wears. Keep those questions coming. I'm gonna keep the answers going your way. Okay, more questions. Anne from Ireland, she writes, what type of clothes should she wear? She's showing a standard poodle. So Anne, I mean, whatever you're comfortable in, we know that dog shows are kind of a more old fashioned sport. Most women are wearing dresses or a skirt and a jacket. To me, if you have a skirt and a jacket with pockets, you're ahead of the game. Just make sure you can run with it. I don't know how many times I've had the sales ladies look at me funny as I'm like putting on a skirt and then kind of running around the boutique, but if I can do it, you can do it. Anne's next question is, why when we show the poodles do we put the chain, like not just keep it on the show side, but go all the way under the jaw and then back? Well, that's because then when the chain is under the jaw and you're on this side, it kind of pulls their chin up and just reminds them of where to carry their head. It's just a little trick I use. I really like it. It's in poodle handling if you haven't seen me do that before, but give it a whirl. I think it'll work for you. And Anne had a third question. She has a friend who has a miniature poodle and can't get the front of its top knot to grow. That's a tricky place because the front of the top knot takes all the abuse. It's the one that takes the brunt of the abuse when you're putting a collar on and off. Everybody, even strangers with dirty hands, touch your dog on the front of the top knot. All those little, you know, it goes through a bush, through a gate, into its crate, anywhere it sticks its head looking for cookies in a drawer, in the garbage can, every single time. That front piece of the top knot takes the abuse. My advice, slick it up. Put some oil in it, put some Spectrum One Hydro Pack in it. Do something to keep it really slick to help combat against that breakage. I think that's natural breakage. It happens to my dogs too. So I just slick them up with lots of conditioner, usually the Spectrum One, whenever I have the chance. And I find that that really helps. So Anne, thanks for those three awesome questions. And you know, write me back if you have more. I love to have repeat customers here. Jan from Czechoslovakia writes, he has a Rhodesian Ridgeback. And he said that she now is starting to put her front legs forward and kind of concaving her chest a little bit when he's stacking her. And what can he do to try to combat that? So I would work on target training, like always getting her to look forward when I go in the ring. I would use bait to pull her up over her front. I would stop practicing things that give her the opportunity to get into that habit. And that's a hard thing to say because you're trying to train the habit out but not reinforce it. If you have time, you know, we have that awesome course, Positive Reinforcement for Show Dogs, and it's a great course. Like, I didn't do the course. We're lucky to have it on our school, but that is how I have trained every single dog that I have shown for the past 30 years. So really, give it a whirl. It's worth every penny. And you know, you can subscribe to the school now and get that, all of our courses, for one low, low monthly fee. So you might want to think about that. Sharon has another question about top knots too. So what she's talking about is when she does a top knot, she feels that her dog doesn't really have enough hair for the fan all the way back. But when she leaves all the hair loose, it's too much hair. When she pulls it all up in the top knot, it looks like a little sprout on the top. So Sharon, check out the top knot series, The Ultimate Guide to Top Knots, and in there is Puppy Cheater Band. I would still use Puppy Cheater Band, like that method, on anything that I was having that problem with. I've often used it on 12 to 18s. I've used it on specials that just needed a little bit of fill before their ears. So use the Puppy Cheater Band, just figure out where you need it to give height where you need it and to give fullness where you need it. And I think that'll really help you. So thanks Sharon for that question. Donna wants to know, how do I start my puppy's stack training and how do I change that stack training into free baiting? I don't really ever train my dogs to free bait until they're older. So, you know, I literally start my stack training with like a bath mat on top of a washing machine because, you know, my dogs are always going in and out the door of the laundry room. Every time they come in, I'll just have a little box of treats there. I throw them up on the bath mat and I literally stack them and let count to five, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And just I'm baiting them forward. I'm telling them they're good. It's always positive, positive, positive. It's just, then I build up, right? So then I count to 10, then I do it with a distraction, then I do it in another place. But it literally starts with just, you know, twice a day, they get literally 15 to 30 seconds on the washing machine on a bath mat. Sounds dumb, but honestly, that's how I do it. And again, there's a lot of stack training in that course, Positive Reinforcement for the Show Dog. So, you know, I would give that a whirl. I can't say enough about it. It's really great for those looking to train their dog. Pam, we have seen, Pam is our frequent flyer. I love you, Pam, because like every week you give me a new question, every week you make me think, every week it's something a little bit different. So this week's questions from Pam are the angle to trim the feet on our Havanese. So Pam, what I like to do, obviously we don't want our Havanese feet over trimmed. I clearly clean up the bottoms of the pads with straight scissors. Then I'm gonna comb the hair out on the foot. I'm gonna give the foot a little shake to mimic the natural movement of my Havanese. And then when the foot is on the ground in a natural position, I'm just going to have, basically my scissors are skimming along the floor or the top of the table. So like picture them flat with the top of the table. So these would be my scissors on the top of the table. And then I would just slightly bevel them up from there. So maybe, I'm not very good with percentages, but you know, I would just slightly tip my scissors up just so I can get around those hairs. But I always trim the hairs, you know, because sometimes our dog's toes are pointing straight ahead, but the hair is kind of going off at an angle. So if the hair is going off to the left, don't keep trimming that hair, like coming down to the left, trim it in the opposite way, because if every little hair is beveled in the opposite way, sooner or later that hair is going to more appear like it's going straight. I might have to send you a diagram, Pam, but I might put that in one of the courses. So if you guys are out there and you want more clarification on that, hit reply on my next email, send me a Facebook message, I'll get to it. Pam also wants to know if she should wrap or not wrap. Really, I probably wouldn't wrap a Havanese. I find that their hair is really fine. They have that like kind of woolier undercoat and finer top coat, which is harder to wrap. Also, their hair shouldn't really be dragging on the ground. So to me, then you shouldn't wrap it because you kind of want that natural breakage as it hits the ground. You definitely don't want it like a Yorkie. That's why we wrap our Yorkies in our Shih Tzus. You know, it's a bit of a different look. I might wrap like maybe around the butt, you know, especially for a girl in season, but typically I don't wrap my Havanese. My favorite products for Havanese, another Pam question, Chris Christensen Tame It shampoo. Again, I always stick with the Afterbath conditioner because I like that 30% extra time to myself. And I use the Ice on Ice spray or the Ice on Ice in the continuous spray aerosol. Because it's just like a great conditioner, really helps get the brush through there, helps the coat repel dirt. So pretty awesome. Caitlin is one of my favorite people. In January, she didn't know how to put the collar on her dog, and now she's working on his grand championship. So kudos to Caitlin. And she has an Aussie going through coat change, and she's been told a million different things. What I do when my dogs are going through coat change, I bath them at least every week. If I'm showing them and they're going through coat change, I bath them twice a week. The sooner you get that dead hair out, the sooner the new hair can come in. Each hair follicle only has room for one hair. So if that hair is dead, but just being held in there by the hair around it, or is almost ready to come out, but like maybe needs some help, like a strong breeze, definitely bathing and drying is going to help. So my dogs going through coat change, if anything, are going to get an extra bath. I'm not going to skip a bath. Laura asked a question. She has a shy Chihuahua. And what should she do? So Laura, I really want you to check positive reinforcement for show dogs, but I also want you to really help your Chihuahua. I want you to go to dog shows and like never really put it on the ground in the beginning till she gets over it. Like maybe stand at ringside or at a busy part of the dog show where you're not in everybody's way, or maybe just slightly, you know, off the beaten track, like with your dog on a grooming table, feeding it its special treats. Teaching it a trick really helps. So like when she gets really scared, she can just default to just doing her trick and forget about all the distractions and how scared she is. And if she's, you know, on a table, she's gonna, you know, those little dogs, everything is big and scary to them. So if you can put them on a table so that they at least have a little bit more height and they can look down at some of those scary things instead of always looking up, that might help. So again, if you need to write me, Laura, for more information, feel free. Like I'm more than happy to help you. Okay, our last question is from Greece and it's about a standard poodle and the woman's name is Gelly, I think. I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name. Gelly. It has a black standard poodle and it has a lot of problems with its ear hair, like no matter what she does with the ear hair. And I took a look at the photo she sent and the front of the ear hair seems really broken. So I would go to the Ultimate Guide to Top Knots and look at double wrapping. That's one of the things. I would get Spectrum 1 Hydro Pack and really slick those ears down with some Hydro Pack. And I would band the front of that ear. The way you had the one band holding the hair from both sides of the ear together wouldn't be my go-to, because then you're causing more wrapping and more damage. I would more band the ear down the front and then to a band or a wrapper at the bottom. And make sure that you put a little piece of paper towel or J cloth underneath that wrapper to hold in those loose ends. So again, the way you have the ear wrapped with the band on the top of the entire ear, I think is a mistake. I would do a band down the front and make sure there's a piece of paper towel or something in my wrapper at the bottom. And you might also have to change these bands and wraps like a little bit more than ideal, like maybe every day or every other day until you can kind of see what's really working, like what combination of bands are working. But I hope that helps. And again, if anybody needs more clarification, feel free to send me an email, a text, however you want to get the question to me is perfectly fine. I really, really enjoyed all of these questions. It was a really busy week and I was just trying to get caught up on some questions that I'd put off for a week or so, but we're really enjoying getting this. So please, you know, if you want these questions to keep coming and getting answered, please like go to leadingedgedogshowacademy.com, look at our great courses. You can sign up for the entire school for a low monthly fee. So every time we add a new course, we're gonna add it for free, just like Netflix. You can see it whenever you want, however many times you want. Or you can just buy a course a la carte. We're easy. However you want us to help you, whatever courses you want to see, we want to help you do that. Again, questions and answers going to be on YouTube every week. So if you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, then you're not going to miss a single episode. And we would love, love, love to have a question from you. So that's it for now. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next week. Hi guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please give us a like, and if you haven't already done so, you can subscribe to our channel below. Also, check out leadingedgedogshowacademy.com for our premium content. We had a lot of fun bringing you all this information. See you soon. Bye.